Well, about 40 seconds have already gone by, and I'd say it's about time to come in here and say good evening. Welcome to Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce. And as I often do, I sit here a few minutes before coming on the air and greeting you, just to see what direction my mind is taking me. This program is unscripted, and we get into various kinds of thought patterns and ideas and topics. Tonight, I sort of reached beyond the border. By that, I mean outside of our understanding, for instance, into space. Or questions such as, what is it like 1 minute after you die? Not to be gloomy, necessarily, but it's something that every one of us is going to have to deal with sometime or another. And as I mentioned, it does not have to be gloomy or maudlin or depressing. In fact, I was just reading an article by a very well-known pastor in Chicago, Dr. Erwin Lutzer. Maybe you're used to hearing his name on Songs in the Night. He's the narrator of that program, has been for years. He was actually writing in a very well-known magazine about what happens after death, especially to those who believe in Jesus Christ, who conquered death at the resurrection. That's why we celebrate Easter. And one of the paragraphs in here, he asked the question, what can you expect as a believer 1 minute after you die? Well, he said, while relatives sorrow on earth, you will find yourself in new surroundings which just now are beyond our imaginations. Most probably, you will see angels who've been assigned to escort you to your destination. Just as the angels carried Lazarus to Abraham's bosom in the Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 16, verse 22. Tonight's program is entitled Think Ahead. Do any of you recall a sort of a funny sign that came out years ago? It was supposed to bring a message of sorts, and it had those two words, think ahead. But the printer evidently misjudged the space he had, and the last three letters were sort of crunched into each other, like they'd hit the brick wall or something. So the message was, plan ahead, think ahead, not only in the amount of letters needed in the space on a line, but the basic message was, think ahead in your life. Tonight's program is exactly that. It has to do with 1 minute after death. Who of us really knows? But the Bible does have something to say about it all. Our music tonight will be comforting, and the lyrics, even of instrumentals, have to do with thinking ahead in our life. As David said in Psalm 23, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. And even that one sentence makes all the difference in the world. Who is with us as we pass through the shadow? Tonight's program, Think Ahead. We want our music to be comforting too. That's why I've asked Phil Driscoll, master trumpeter, to play for us one of the old songs about Jesus, whom we will be with as we trust in Him forever.
Thank you.
Beautiful orchestration there, excellent trumpet playing, Phil Driscoll and Company. One of the old songs we haven't heard for a good long time. We shall see his lovely face some bright, glorious morning. This is Night Sounds, I'm Bill Pearce. What can you expect as a believer in Jesus Christ 1 minute after you die? You are keenly aware that you have arrived in heaven, and as you enter its gates, you see Christ, who welcomes you home. Since he stood to welcome Stephen into the glories of heaven, in Acts chapter 7, verse 56. So, it's reasonable to believe he will be on hand to bid those who love and trust him, those in his family, as they enter. We'll know who he is, and certainly he would quite obviously know who we are if we believe in him, because we're part of his family. He calls you and me by name. We can look into his eyes and see compassion, love, understanding that we never saw on earth. And Mr. Lutzer continued, though you feel altogether unworthy, you know his welcome is genuine. You see the nail prints in his hands, which trigger memories that make you fall on your face in worship. And were it not for his tender hand helping you to your feet, you'd not be able to get up. Part of this is certainly conjecture, but as understanding the Word of God, it seems to me that some people have an extra glimpse in their hearts and minds and psyches, and I'm not getting into the psychic thing here, but there are those who have sensitivities given by God to tell us about it, to comfort us by His Spirit through His Word. So much is different in heaven, to say the least. Yet you are quite the same, he said. You have entered heaven without a break in consciousness. Back on earth, your friends will bury your body, but they cannot bury you. Just before Stephen died, he said, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. He didn't say receive my body in Acts 7:59. Our personality will continue. Dr. Erwin Lutzer, whom we're quoting tonight, said, 1 minute after we die, our minds, our memories will be clearer than ever before. And we're reminded of Jesus' story in Luke, of the rich man who went to Hades with his memory intact. He knew his family on earth, pleading, I have five brothers. Death does not change what we know. Our personalities will go on with the same information we've stored in our minds today. What about sorrow? Somebody asked if we think we would have any remorse in heaven. Revelation chapter 7, verse 17. Yes, there might be a certain amount of remorse and remembrances of the past. There will be sorrow until God wipes away every tear from our eyes. When we think of the opportunities we squandered, when we consider how imperfectly we loved Christ on earth, there probably will be a certain amount of grief and remembrance. But such sorrow will vanish, because now the reality of what could have been dawns on us. Tonight's program, Think Ahead. I'm so glad you're there. I'm going to take just a few minutes break here and let you know that Night Sounds is on the air, and we will be leaving in a few moments. But when we do, I want to make sure that you have something in your hand. So many of you write and ask for copies of certain programs. Perhaps you have loved ones who've gone on before you into the glories of heaven, and you'd like to know more about this. That's why we make available copies of programs, which our announcer will tell you about at the end of our program. And prayer. Until we get there, we uphold one another in prayer. Our burdens, we're still beleaguered here by pain and sorrow and suffering and stress and friction, but there it will be no more. However, we do continue in the reality of these moments, but with hope. If we can pray for you and help with your concerns, we want to do this. We meet together once a week, a couple of us, and we remember not only personally but individually your prayers. We discuss them. We want to know as much about them as we can, so if you do send in prayer requests, please, if you would, let us know as much detail as possible so we can pray intelligently for you. Our mailing address is Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. If you'd like more information on this outreach, the phone number is area 815-636-9350. For those of you with computers who like to use email, it's nightsoundsradio, that's one word, at aol.com. We play music on the program all the time. Some of it we've been privileged to produce in the past, and there are about 10 to 13 albums now. I say 10, 11, 12, 13. I'm not sure how many albums we've done, more than those. But these are available through Night Sounds. If you'd like to ask for information or send for a catalog, that'd be the better idea. It would save time. Our mailing address, once again, Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Now and then we break from the traditional and get into the contemporary music, because we do have a lot of younger listeners with us each night. Right now I'd like to call on one of the foremost contemporary singers of our day, Stephen Curtis Chapman, as he sings about a song that he wrote with two words. It's with hope. We will all pass through the shadow of death unless Jesus Christ comes and takes us home with him before that moment of death arrives. How are we going to face it? With hope or with futility? Let's listen. Let's look ahead with our singer as he reminds us of those moments ahead of us. This is Night Sounds presenting Stephen Curtis Chapman with music of hope and joy.
This is not at all how we thought it was supposed to be. Had so many plans for you, we had so many dreams, and now you've gone away and left us with the memories of your smile, and nothing we can say and nothing we can do can take away the pain of losing you. But we can cry. We can say goodbye with hope, 'cause we know our goodbye is not the end. Oh, and we can breathe with hope, 'cause we believe with hope there's a place where we'll see your face again. So hard to understand. I never have I questioned more the wisdom of God's plan. But through the cloud of tears, I see the Father smile and say, well done. And I imagine you where you wanted most to be, seeing all your dreams come true. Now you're home and now you're free. And we can cry with hope. We can say goodbye with hope. 'Cause we know our goodbye is not the end. Oh no. And we can grieve with hope. 'Cause we believe with hope there's a place where we'll see. See your face again.
God promised us is true. So we can cry with hope, we can say goodbye with hope, 'cause we know our goodbye is not the end. Oh,
Stephen Curtis Chapman, the song With Hope. And the subtitle of our time together, Think Ahead, certainly suggesting that we consider the future. 1 minute after we die. That's the subject matter, too, that we're considering tonight. Ann Martindale wrote, "Oh, how endless seems my walk. And I wish I'd hear God say, you've walked so far and are so weary. Come on home with me today." Oh, the heartaches and the burdens that his presence would erase. Oh, the warmth my soul would know from the sunshine of his face. Yes, I get a longing to go home and to see the one whose love makes my heart on earth so restless till it rests with him above. Still a pilgrim down on earth, with a longing all the time for the open arms of Jesus and the home I know is mine. You can see how personal this is, because it has to do with family, the family of God. Paul, the apostle of Jesus, had no illusions as to whether heaven was better than earth. He was just longing to depart and be with Christ, which he said is better by far. And even our heroic attempts to extend our lives by a few days with respirators and other high-tech equipment would seem unnecessary if we could see what awaits us. Only on this side of the curtain is death our enemy. But just beyond that curtain, the monster turns out to be our friend. The label death is still on the bottle, but the contents are life eternal. Death can be our friend because it reminds us that heaven is near. So again, the strong suggestion is that we plan ahead, think ahead, accept Jesus Christ and his provision for you and me after we die. If you've never done it before, would you accept him into your heart, your life, your mind, intellect, thoughts, spirit, everything that makes you uniquely who you are? We want to close our program tonight musically with a beautiful song of the gospel speaking of the return of Jesus. As you know, historically, the eastern gate of Jerusalem is walled up until the time that Jesus returns, when it will then be open as he passes through. There are many graves on the other side of that closed gate, because those who want to be the first to see him at that moment that he comes through have asked to be buried there. Not superstition, just anticipation. But here's a song with which the 16 singing men close our time together tonight, a beautiful number entitled "The Eastern Gate." As we listen, these are moments of reflection and prayer, introspection and thinking of the future, our future personally.
I will meet you in the morning.
Just a word for those of you who are concerned about your future and destiny. In Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 13, God says, "You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all of your heart. I will be found by you, declares the Lord." Think about it. Plan ahead. Till we meet again, thanks so much for being there. May God bless you, give you a good day tomorrow, and until we meet once more, a peaceful good night to each and every one of you.
Thanks for listening to this digitally delivered edition of Night Sounds with Bill Pearce. Before you log out, please support our web and app platforms by clicking the Donate tab. Your generous contribution helps us continue bringing Night Sounds to you with new technologies. Thanks for listening to the digital edition of Night Sounds with Bill Pearce.